What are the benefits of being a mutant? We've all imagined some kind of special X-Men-esque magic power that's our own to wield against the forces of evil. Beneficial mutations in nature provide examples of evolution in action and result in the formation of major innovations and rare and complex traits that over time have resulted in the evolution of all living things. You want snakes? How about one with two heads? Or a frog with three faces? A ghost bear? Stay tuned. Here are the 15 craziest animal mutations in the world.
He's growling again. You have had it with this, huh?
Number 15. The spirit bear. Neither albino nor polar bear, the spirit bear is a white variant of the North American black bear and is found almost exclusively in the Great Bear Rainforest, 25,000 square miles, 1.5 times as big as Switzerland, down Canada's western coast. Geneticists learned that the spirit bear's coloration results from a mutation in a gene involved in the production of melanin. The trait is recessive. Both parents must carry a copy of the mutated gene for their offspring to be white. In the Great Bear Rainforest, some 500 to 1200 black bears might be carriers, but no one really knows how many bears there are in the Great Bear Rainforest. The Kermode bear definitely sticks out though. The white bear has been known to the local indigenous community as the spirit or ghost bear for thousands of years. They revere every living thing, but the spirit bear is especially sacred. It's one of the rarest bears on Earth. There are as few as 100 according to some estimates. Now, let's get ready for today's open discussion. The famous photoshopped image of a mutated newborn kangaroo baby or a joey created quite a buzz. Is it a baby red kangaroo? And clearly, whomever created the image was trying to get our attention. It's very unusual. Mutations are changes in the genetic sequence, a main cause of diversity among organisms like a baby kangaroo. These changes occur at many different levels and they can have widely differing consequences. But it can make it hard for us humans to identify regular everyday creatures, perhaps. And without fear, hopefully, mutations mean you never know what you might get. Join the discussion, comment down below using the hashtag OpenDiscussion. You want to know a little secret? If you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you'll have superpowers for the rest of your life. So what are you waiting for? Time to fly. Number 14. The wild animals of Chernobyl. On April 26, 1986, the worst accident in the history of the nuclear industry occurred in Chernobyl, Ukraine. It contaminated 150,000 square miles. While humans are strictly prohibited from living in the Chernobyl exclusion zone nowadays, many other species have settled there. Brown bears, wolves, lynx, bison, deer, moose, beavers, foxes, badgers, wild boar, raccoon dogs, and more than 200 species of birds. A variety of amphibians, fish, worms, and bacteria makes the unpopulated environment their home too. Some biologists have been surprised that the incidence of physical mutations appears lower than the blast of radiation would have suggested. There have been some oddities recorded within the area, such as partial albinism among barn swallows, but researchers think that the serious mutations mostly happened directly after the explosion. Though experts today believe parts of the zone will remain unsafe for humans for another 20,000 years, numerous animal and plant species not only survived, but thrived. What do you know? Number 13. Florida Everglade mutant pythons. The capture of 5 African rock pythons recently in the Florida Everglades, already teeming with the gentler Burmese pythons, has scientists worried about so-called hybrid vigor when interbreeding uncorks volatile recessive genes, passing traits such as aggression onto the offspring. While Burmese pythons aren't known to eat people in their native habitat, the African rock python, unfortunately, has been known to do just that. Already squeezed by the invasion of the giant Burmese python, Florida now faces what one scientist calls one of the U.S. state's worst nightmares. Africa's largest snake, the ill-tempered 20-foot-long African rock python, is colonizing Florida. 6 African rock pythons have been found in Florida since 2002. More troubling, a pregnant female and 2 hatchlings have been found, which means the aggressive reptiles are getting cozy together. So far, the giant snakes have been found only in a single square mile of suburban area west of Miami. Pet breeders who are unprepared for the python's ferocity may have released them. Attack of the mutant pythons. Number 12. The Seneca white deer. For years, there have been rumors about a strange herd of white deer living in the former Seneca Army Depot in Seneca County, New York. Freak accidents and an army experiment gone wrong. Others have attributed the animal's appearance to radioactivity. Neither of these rumors, however, are true. The white deer were first spotted around 1941 when the U.S. Army fenced off 24 square miles of land. The deer population thrived, and along with it, a recessive gene for white coloration. Though the animals appeared to be albino, they were in fact white-tailed deer who carried the recessive gene for an all-white coat. In the 1950s, the U.S. Army decided to protect the unique herd. Since then, the white deer population has grown to approximately 300, making it the largest herd of white deer in the world. Since November 2017, 90-minute bus tours of the site have become available. On the tour, you'll learn about some of the base history as well as about the deer. And while sightings are not guaranteed, the guides know the best places to find them for visitors to see and photograph. Number 11. Three-headed frog. Wildlife experts have been rocked by the discovery of a three-headed frog hopping around the garden of a children's nursery. Staff believe the mutant amphibian was three frogs huddled together at first, but they soon realized it was just one animal with three croaking heads. Frogs have a very primitive embryology, so the occasional extra toe is not that unusual. But the reason for the three-headed frog's development could have been damage to the embryo, a spontaneous mutation such as that of conjoined human twins, or factors in the environment, including pollution and changing climate. It seems to be an example of Siamese birth whereby three individual animals all have arisen from the same fertilized embryo, but they haven't divided properly. We know this can happen because it happens in other animals. If you look at the pictures, the lower frog does appear to have different characteristics to the other two frogs. It's not unusual to find more than one male frog clinging very tightly to a female. They get very randy and will not let go in the breeding season. Number 10. Mutant zebrafish. A group of scientists have observed how the brains of genetically defective zebrafish embryos develop in fine detail. Their findings could be used to help develop better treatments for disorders like autism or schizophrenia in humans. During embryonic development, zebrafish are transparent, which makes them ideal for observation. You can see right through them, which makes them great test beds for developing therapies for a whole suite of human disease, including genetic brain disorders. So the see-through embryos are not mutants, but actually have a superpower. By introducing a defective gene into zebrafish embryos, they noted a distinctly different pattern of brain growth between them and normal ones. While the genetic underpinnings of certain brain diseases is well established, the mechanics of how this is expressed were, until now, still a bit of a mystery. The team found that the mutant embryos appeared to develop a distinct clustering of brain cells that may disrupt ordinary brain development and later function. This could be major for treating human genetic brain disorders in the future. Number 9. Medusa, the two-headed snake. Meet Medusa, a two-headed albino Honduran milk snake. That's right, twice the forked tongues, twice the fangs. The two-headed reptile was born in captivity and currently resides in Florida. She can be yours for the bargain price of 50 grand. The two heads were actually identical twins that split from one embryo to become two. But the twin embryos fused after splitting, producing the very unique Medusa. But the two-headed Medusa is unlike most milk snakes, as she's the perfect example of axial bifurcation, meaning she's perfectly symmetrical. Feeding times can often be difficult having two heads because they both often fight each other for food, so they have to be separated with a piece of card. "This snake is perfect," says the owner. Some other two-headed snakes are beautiful, but they have a kink where the heads become one. Medusa doesn't. It's as if she was meant to have two heads. Medusa's owner already holds a Guinness World Record for having the biggest collection of two-headed animals, but considers Medusa the crowning jewel. And we can see why. Two heads is better than one. Number 8. The rare blue lobster. A Red Lobster employee who found a blue lobster in a delivery to the eatery recognized just how rare the creatures are. About one of every 2 million lobsters is blue. A rough analysis of overall catch tonnages suggests about 200 million lobsters are caught in the North Atlantic every year. That equates to 100 blue ones turning up in a year on average, if the 1 in 2 million odds are correct. And while this discovery is very rare, it's far from the first time a colored lobster has been discovered. In 2019, a Massachusetts restaurant found blue lobster in its shipment and sent it to a local aquarium. A few months later, a fisherman in Maine caught a rare cotton candy-colored lobster, not once, but twice. And just a month later, another fisherman in the area caught a 2-ton red and black lobster, a 1 in 50 million find. Typically, lobsters come in murky brown, dark green, or even deep navy blue colors. But in extremely rare instances, these crustaceans exhibit vibrant hues of yellow, cotton candy pink, and bright blue. Like blue clawed from red lobster. Number 7. Henry the Hexapus. Henry the Hexapus was a six-limbed lesser octopus found by British scientists in 2008. The name alludes to King Henry VIII, who had six wives. The octopus was found off the coast of North Wales in a lobster pot and was held in captivity in northwest England. His unusual number of arms was not immediately noticed and appears to have resulted from a natural anomaly rather than a physical accident. After being taken from the sea, Henry was transferred in the zoo and quickly became popular. He was featured in an exhibition entitled Suckers, too. An aquarium spokesperson stated that he's a lovely little thing. We couldn't agree more. Many other octopus arms anomalies have been recorded in the past. American tourists visiting Portugal also claim to have captured images of a six-limbed octopus, although experts could not confirm the sighting without additional information. Another family of American tourists did capture a hexapus in Greece in 2013, as verified by photographs, but cooked and ate it with lemon and tzatziki. Yum! Number 6. Two-headed shark. A bunch of rare two-headed sharks have been found from California to the Caribbean and from Mexico to the Mediterranean, leading scientists to ponder why. Reminiscent of the classic Simpsons three-eyed fish, Blinky, the mutated sharks are raising eyebrows. A few years ago off Florida, fishermen hauled in a bull shark whose uterus contained a two-headed fetus. In 2008, another fisherman discovered a two-headed bull shark embryo in the Indian Ocean. And in 2011, study described conjoined twins discovered in blue sharks caught in the Gulf of California and northwestern Mexico. Blue sharks have produced the most record two-headed embryos because they carry so many babies, up to 50 at a time. Now, Spanish researchers have identified an embryo of an Atlantic sawtail cat shark with two heads, according to a new study. While raising sharks for human health research in the laboratory, a team noticed the unusual embryo in a see-through shark egg. Two-headed sharks may sound like a figment of the big screen, but they exist, and more are turning up worldwide. Number 5. Venus, the two-faced cat. This cute three-year-old kitty's name is Venus. She's famous for her two faces. So what exactly does that mean? Is she two animals in one, with two separate sets of DNA wrapped in one cute kitty covering? And yes, that is a thing. Venus is not necessarily a chimera, an animal whose cells contain two sets of DNA caused when two embryos fuse together during development. See, the black coloration could have randomly activated in all of the cells on one side of her adorable kitty face, while cells coding for orange coloration kicked in on the other side. The two patches then met in the middle as she developed in the womb. But it's Venus's single blue eye that's the real mystery. Cats usually sport yellow or green eyes. Those with baby blue eyes tend to have Siamese heritage and predominantly white cats. Venus, however, only has a small white patch on her chest, not enough to explain the blue eye. But to find out for sure whether or not Venus is a chimera, she'd need to perform genetic testing. Number 4. South Carolina orange alligators. These orange alligators that look like they took a bath in some bad self-tanner after a cheesy colored alligator from the Charleston area made headlines all over the world, a man spotted two of the reptiles sunbathing next to a neighborhood pond. Usually, South Carolina gators only make headlines when they're incredibly large or when they've done something strange. Experts have a simple explanation for the brightly colored swamp creatures. It's likely due to alligators hibernating somewhere near rust, like by an old drainage pipe. A spokesperson told reporters, it's like if you stuck your hand in a bucket of rusty water where metal had been sitting for a while. During the winter, the alligators like to dig in and find a place to hibernate. Is it possible that some end up near drainage pipes that have rusty metal pieces inside? So basically, they marinate in rust all winter, and this stains them. Locals don't see orange alligators every year, which is why they get so much attention. Number 3. Stumpy the Four-Legged Duck. It sounds like the title of a famous children's fable about a special bird. Stumpy was born at a duck farm in the New Forest, Hampshire, to the great surprise of the owner, who was gobsmacked when she first turned Stumpy over after her birth to find out the duckling's sex and was confronted by a preponderance of legs. The rare mutation has left the bird with two legs behind the two he runs about on, and he was not expected to live for very long, and he almost didn't. Stumpy the duck, born with four legs, is only three quarters the chap he used to be. After catching one of his feet in chicken wire, he had to have the entire limb amputated. But the accident turned out to be a blessing in disguise. The new streamlined three-legged Stumpy can waddle much faster than before, enabling him to catch up with his lady friend Alice the duck when he's feeling amorous. And their owners believe it will not be long before the couple have a brood of ducklings to keep them on their toes. Number 2. The King Cheetah. The King Cheetah is one of the rarest animals in the world. Only 10 are believed to exist in the wild, with a further 50 in captivity. With its unusual markings, the King Cheetah was once considered a different species. However, it's usually the exact same as the African cheetah, other than a mutated fur pattern. As the gene is recessive, it's very hard for King Cheetahs to reproduce more of their own kind. Both parents must have the recessive gene, so it takes two King Cheetahs to make a King Cheetah cub. Most sources claim that King Cheetah have only been seen in the wild a total of six times. Six times! That's in the whole of Africa over the last 100 years. They've been spotted in Botswana, Zimbabwe, and northern South Africa. The last confirmed wild sighting was back in 1986. That was over 30 years ago. Look back 400 years and there's a good chance that a lot of them prowled the African plains. However, such an incredible fur coat would have been a prime target for any hunter. Global cheetah numbers have declined immensely over the last 100 years, so it shouldn't be a surprise that the even rarer kings haven't been seen. Number 1. Frank and Louie. And for our final entry on today's list, we have Frank and Louie, the world's longest surviving Janus cat that passed away at the tender age of 15. Janus cats are named after the Roman god Janus, who was known for having two faces in ancient mythology. Those were 15 of the craziest animal mutations in the world. Thanks for watching.